Because actually, if you look at the picture, the latest studies by UNESCO paint a very grim picture of education in Africa. Some classrooms in urban Senegal have over 100 students, so too in Cameroon and in other African countries. In sub-Saharan Africa, there are twice as many men than women in university. But despite these seemingly unsurmountable problems, I would say, UNESCO International Institute for Capacity Building believes that the future of Africa is bright.
L'Institut international pour le renforcement des capacités, créé en 1999, est venu à un moment très très approprié, dans la mesure où cette institution quand même focalise sur des sujets extrêmement importants pour les systèmes éducatifs africains, notamment les questions de formation des enseignants, les questions de développement du curriculum, les questions de l'éducation à distance et certainement au-dessus de tout ça, les questions de planification et de gestion de l'éducation. Et donc nous pensons que l'Institut est arrivé à un moment où la plupart des pays africains faisaient face à d'énormes difficultés dans ces domaines et le fait de vouloir focaliser ses activités sur de tels domaines prouve certainement que IICBA est extrêmement important dans le contexte africain aujourd'hui.
Pendant les trois premières années de son existence, IICBA a fait beaucoup de choses, au point d'ailleurs que le conseil d'administration, quelquefois, est arrivé à demander à la directrice de réduire ses activités pour se concentrer sur un certain nombre assez restreint. Et par exemple, IICBA a beaucoup déjà travaillé dans le domaine de la formation des formateurs, la formation des maîtres, dans l'éducation à distance et dans la production de matériel didactique. Et les résultats se font déjà sentir sur le continent dans un certain nombre de pays.
So it was felt that our job would be to strengthen institutions within the continent. At the same time, we don't have any other institute that is working on teacher education. So we are trying to do teacher education, try and improve the institutions, that is the colleges and faculties of education.
Even those that have not had the opportunity to go to school, those mostly women or young girls that drop out, we also have programs. We have programs for street children.
And at the same time utilize distance education so we can have kind of critical mass. We can train everybody in the college or faculty so that the issue of brain drain is minimized.
I've been working with IICBA for 4 years. They've wanted someone to go around and provide IT support to the local countries, because what they're finding is they have a lot of infrastructure and hardware coming from donor nations, but what they don't have is training. So they're looking for design technology, design information, material and classes. I think by just giving them design skills, by giving them web design skills, multimedia, graphic design skills, focusing on what the particular needs are within each region. When I'm going to Sudan, I'm going to be giving advanced web design, because I look at their work now and I can see that they've reached a certain level, but they need to work beyond that. They need to improve their skills. So I want to go there and provide advanced web design, advanced multimedia, and working with databases and working with the web applications. So to increase their capacity to work in a higher level.
Now we are developing a master degrees program for educational planners in the governments in Africa. So we are developing the master degrees course for them, and also we are developing a short course for economic planners so that eventually they can be equipped with economic skills and education skills, education planning skills, so that they can work together collaboratively. That's why we ourselves, as UNESCO, we need to work with other organizations or institutions which are involved in the economic sectors, so that eventually, as Africa, African regions, we can have such an idea as education and economic sectors work together. This is our vision.
Yeah, multi-grade school is meant really to give access to students of different age and also of different backgrounds under one teacher. Actually, multi-grade basically is rural-oriented, one. Two, it's within the community so that the students can come in the morning and also can work in the afternoon with the parents, because rural area, you know, child labor is very, very important. And also it helps the girls to come to school without fear of being abducted or being attacked by, you know, by just bad people. You know, this is not a part of the formal school system of the country. It's an experimental base. And UNESCO was interested to get involved in this because it's part of the capacity building.
UNESCO also gives trainings, different kinds of trainings. So the trainings that we've had in our department has been the video trainings.
He's saying that, first of all, in our culture, you are supposed to have gotten married when you are a virgin.
Yes.
Which is right, and
it's important to use video for HIV because it's kind of entertaining the kids and doing such stuff. So it's great using video.
Very few really have that knowledge about, you know, sexually transmitted diseases. Some are poor young girls, you know, looking for a livelihood because they come from very poor homes. So when they meet an infected man with money, you know, can promise them the world, they very rarely think about HIV/AIDS. But with a video, bringing the situation, giving it life, you know, it makes an impact.
You know, UNESCO is a regional institute, so we are concerned with all countries in Africa, and in many of these countries there is a high shortage of teachers, and distance education is currently used by many African countries to train teachers so that they will have a large number.
Nous avons développé pour l'IICBA un programme de formation à distance de deuxième cycle universitaire pour les professeurs d'université en Afrique afin de les aider à utiliser les technologies dans leur enseignement, dans leur travail et même dans leurs travaux de recherche. Ce programme, dans sa première phase, se déroule uniquement avec l'université de Yaoundé, avec des universités du Cameroun. Dans la deuxième phase, 4 autres pays vont être inclus, le Burkina Faso, le Mali, le Rwanda et la République démocratique du Congo.
Currently, we have students from Ethiopia, 102 about, students from Madagascar, very few there, about 5, and then about 30-35 in Liberia. And then we just started to extend this program to Ghana, in two universities, University of Cape Coast and University of Education at Winneba.
Nous pensons que ce programme est très important pour l'Afrique. Premièrement, il y a un grand fossé numérique entre l'Afrique et les autres continents, notamment l'Europe et l'Amérique du Nord. Et nous pensons que ce programme, qui renforce les capacités des professeurs d'universités africaines, leur permettra éventuellement de combler ce déficit technologique qui existe entre les pays moins favorisés et ceux du Nord.
And by the time the program from our part is sort of phased out, there will be a lot of people who are well trained in planning, implementing, preparing material for distance education, focusing on teachers.
One of the areas we find is critically important in Africa is the issue of the education of girls and women. For various reasons, girls are less likely to go to high school and less likely to go to university or to tertiary education. For example, only 3.5% of girls go to university in Africa, and this is a very low percentage, and as a result they find it difficult to make an impact because they don't have critical mass. So one of the areas we are working together with the Forum for African Women Educationalists, that is FAWE, is to see how we can strengthen women's leadership in education and also strengthen the number of girls who can get into high school, because almost everywhere in Africa the number of girls may be as low as 4 or 5% of the population. Even in the really better countries it may only be 20-30% of the girls who get into high school.
Je pense que quand on regarde ce que IICBA a pu faire avec le peu de moyens que IICBA a, moyens en termes de ressources financières et en termes de ressources humaines, je crois qu'il y a de quoi féliciter sérieusement IICBA. Donc il est extrêmement important que l'UNESCO mais aussi d'autres partenaires bilatéraux et multilatéraux, tels que la Banque mondiale, par exemple, qui met beaucoup d'argent dans l'éducation de plus en plus, puissent soutenir davantage les activités de ICBA. Et je pense aussi que cela permettrait d'avoir un staff aussi en quantité et en qualité dont ICBA a besoin si ICBA doit aujourd'hui étendre ses activités qui, comme je l'ai dit plus tôt, sont extrêmement importantes pour le contexte africain dans le cadre de l'éducation. Donc nous pensons qu'il faut faire un appel aux partenaires.
Just as you know, one has to say, let's compare a child in a village in Africa and compare a child, say, in New York or in Paris. Are they getting equally good education? And I think that's our job. That's the challenge, that we should ensure that that child in a remote village is getting as good an education as the child in New York or in Paris.